dear viewers, and welcome to a new edition of our program, Africa Today. In today's edition, we are going to talk about the Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development. A few minutes ago, President Sisi addressed the second Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development. In his speech made via video conference, President Sisi said that the continent is still suffering from the conflicts that undermine developmental efforts and called for a unified effort to settle the ongoing conflicts. To shed more light on that forum, we are very much delighted to have with us over the phone Ambassador Gamal Bayoumi, former Assistant Foreign Minister. Ambassador Bayoumi, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon.
Hello, sir. Ambassador Bayoumi, how do you see the significance of this second edition of the Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development?
Very important and a good step on the right track. Now, on the international level, we are asking for the right of development as part of the human rights internationally. Africa also is a continent which is in a bad position relatively concerning and in comparison with other continents. Africa is paying its debts and paying its invoice of imports. Much more money, flow of money towards the developed part of the world, much more than it gets as investment or cash for its exports. This is what we are trying to change, the right of development, sustainable development, and of course to do the efforts to make Africa a peaceful continent also, because we have lot of challenges in many African countries. And here is the main task of the Aswan Forum in order to bring back Africa to peace situation.
Yes.
And also in order for development. And a third goal of the meeting is to tackle the problem of the corona 19,
yes,
from its medical point of view and also from its economic effect.
Indeed.
On the continent, as you well know, the whole world economy is diminishing, except in very few countries in Egypt, in the world. Egypt is among them. Egypt is the only country in Africa which will continue developing according to a positive rate.
Yes.
So that's exactly what the president was saying, that we shall do whatever it takes to give our experience to Africa, to be intermediator between Africa as a recipient continent and between and the donors from the other side, whether to help Africa by grants or to help Africa by loans or to help Africa by investment, which is the best way to help the continent.
Yes.
In order to reach what we call sustainable development and better life in the continent. This will help everybody, even the West, because this will tackle the problem of illegal migration. This will tackle the problem of drug trafficking and terrorism.
Yes.
This will tackle also the money laundering as a big crime we are trying to stop it in the continent.
Yes.
So this is a huge task and a challenge, and we are up to do it, inshallah.
Yes, indeed. Ambassador Bayoumi, in his speech via video conference to the forum, President Sisi said that the continent is still suffering from the conflicts that undermined the development efforts and called for unified efforts in order to settle the ongoing conflicts. What measures can be taken in order to face these challenges that the African continent is still suffering from?
First is to do our homework, that we need a lot of efforts concerning developing our infrastructure. Even this, the president mentioned it, that we are establishing huge roads to connect the continent, that we are going to make our airway traffic serving every capital in Africa. Egypt is doing its homework also by having a representative, whether embassies or consulates, in every place in Africa. also by ameliorating our bureaucracy, because the bureaucracy is a big obstacle against development. I mean here the banking system, the bureaucratic system of the government, and to be matching the international way of development.
Indeed.
And this is a very important point also. With this, we can attract more foreign direct investment to the continent.
Yes.
And to prove that whoever will come to invest in our continent will gain, and we shall support him until he gain money also.
Indeed.
It's not a sort of charity or something like that.
Yes.
But it is mainly
to establish
a sort of a partnership.
Yes.
Between those who have surplus of money and those who need more and more foreign direct investment.
Indeed, Ambassador Gamal Bayoumi, former Assistant Foreign Minister, many thanks for being with us and for your precious input. Always a pleasure, sir. And moving on, indeed, to this very important forum, which was inaugurated today. President Abdel Fattah Sisi addressed on Monday the second Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development. In his speech made via video conference, President Sisi said that the forum is held via video conference due to the coronavirus pandemic. The president said that the continent was in dire need for the infrastructure projects. He noted that Egypt has a leading experience in the infrastructure projects that can be shared with the other African states. President Sisi said that the continent is still suffering from the conflicts that undermine development efforts. The president called for unified efforts to settle the ongoing conflict. Still, to shed light on that very important forum, we are joined by Nile TV's senior correspondent, Taghrid Hussain. Good afternoon to you, Taghrid.
Good afternoon to you, Mahisti.
Taghrid, can you shed light about the second edition of the Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development?
Yes, Mahisi, thank you so much. The forum, Aswan Forum in its second edition, is a very important event taking place under the leadership of His Excellency President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. The president addressed this important forum, and also it was addressed by a number of African leaders. As you know, Mahisi, for this time, the forum has been bringing together leaders from governments, regional as well as international organizations, financial institutions, as well as the private sector and also the civil societies. Mm-hmm. We had also visionaries and scholars and key experts and practitioners for a contest and a specific action-oriented discussion of the new risks and threats and challenges that are facing Africa, as well as also the opportunities that are lying ahead. So, the building on the inaugural Aswan Forum and its conclusions is a main aim, and that came in a speech that was given by His Excellency, Foreign Minister of Egypt, Egypt's top diplomat, Sameh Shoukry. The second edition aims to advance a positive and forward-looking agenda as Africa is charting on its pathway for recovery post-COVID-19. Most importantly, as you know, the forum is also emphasizing on the need to accelerate this shift from crisis management to conflict prevention in an effort in order to strengthen the sense of resilience as an integral part of the strategies to recover stronger and to rebuild better post COVID-19 or post the pandemic. As you know, Mahisi, also Egypt has achieved a lot, the great foundation under the leadership of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi chairing the African Union. It has been a very fruitful year for Egypt. As you know, also that grounded in the African Union Agenda 2063 and the United Nations, the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, the forum is a continuation of championing the African-led solutions and efforts to ensure that national, regional, as well as continental actors are better equipped in order to deal with the new normal and in the wake of COVID-19. Mahisi.
Yes, Taghrid. Taghrid, to what extent the second edition of the forum, the Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development, is building on the achievements of the first edition of the forum?
Yes, it is, Mahisi. It is actually building in a continuation on what has been achieved in the first edition. In this context, it comes focusing on concrete measures to push forward the implementation of the humanitarian development peace nexus, both on the strategic as well as the operational levels, under the supervision of the National Coordination Committee headed by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the Cairo International Center for Conflict Resolution, Peacekeeping, as well as the Peace Building, the CCCPA, acting in its capacity as the secretariat of this forum. It also conducted a series of webinars to prepare for this important event for the whole of Africa taking place, and proposing the set of the suggested actions and the measures that has been undertaken, and in consideration of African and international leaders, strengthening continental as well as global cooperation and also partnerships in order to advance peace, advance security, and also advance sustainability, sustainable development in Africa. The leaders, African leaders addressing the forum, thanked President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi for the effective mechanisms that were put under the leadership of His Excellency the President, and that helped foster and unify the coordination in the African continent.
Indeed. Taghlib, as you have kindly mentioned, that President Sisi, Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry, and African leaders did deliver their speeches via video conference for the second edition of the Aswan Forum. To what extent that is reflecting the importance of the African cooperation in light of the challenges of the COVID-19 pandemic, Taghlib?
Very important sense of coordination that has been going on since the first wave of COVID-19 had hit the whole world, and we've seen this sense of coordination. We've seen that we are looking further also to the conclusions and the recommendations of the second edition. The second edition mainly aims at advancing a positive and forward-looking agenda as Africa is chartering on its pathway for recovery of the post-COVID-19. As you know, most importantly, the forum emphasizes on this need in order to accelerate this shift from crisis management to conflict prevention as well. So this is considered to be a very important, the sense of coordination in the limelight, also facing the other threats and challenges. And not only that, but also the most importantly is also looking forward to opportunities ahead of the African continent.
Yes, Taghlib, the conference is taking place through different days. How do you see the agenda of the forum? And of course, it is tackling mainly the sustainable peace and development in the African continent, Taghlib.
It is, as well as other also items on the agenda. Indeed. You have youth in the African continent and how to empower youth in the African continent. We are talking also women empowerment in Africa, and great steps has been undertaken in that respect. This in addition also to working on the COVID-19 challenge and how we are coordinating, we as African nations in that respect. Talking also the private sector and the role of the civil society as well, since we do have here representatives of the civil society, as well as scholars and key expert practitioners are also present. We do have here also the discussions continue concerning putting a strategy ahead vis-a-vis the agenda and the African charters on a pathway for recovery post-COVID-19. So all the ailments, in addition to the opportunities, are being discussed here. And we're looking forward to the recommendations of this important gathering. It's very important, this sense of coordination. And it is happening at the level, the highest level, on the presidency level, and definitely also on the level of ambassadors and the great thinkers of Africa that we had seen today.
Yes, indeed. And finally, Taghlib, to what extent that is reflecting Egypt's concern regarding the cooperation among the different African nations and its pivotal role in the African continent? To what extent this forum is reflecting that?
It is reflecting that, and all the speeches of the African leaders came reflecting that, came reflecting in appreciation and in admiration of the role President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has played in supporting Africa and supporting African issues and African leadership. And they all admire the role Egypt has played during the chairmanship of the African Union. And that's why we do have now a solid foundation to build on for the future, talking about also other issues concerning the participation of the different categories, the African Continental Free Trade Area, and how those steps has been quite fundamental and has been achieved and launched during the presidency of of the Egyptian chairmanship, during the Egyptian chairmanship of the African Union. So you have a great foundation that has been built, and we're continuing this sense of coordination with the African leaders and with African representatives and with ambassadors who are present here, with scholars and think tanks, because we are thinking for Africa, Africa for tomorrow, the Africa that we aspire. And this is the main aim, talking peace, talking development, and talking sustainability of Africa together. Africa being united, we are definitely strong.
Indeed, Taghrid Hussain, our senior correspondent from the Aswan Forum. Many thanks for your very precious input, Taghrid. Thank you very much. Our dear viewers, that was our special coverage for the second Aswan Forum for Sustainable Peace and Development. Many thanks for watching.